Welcome to Partner Talks, a podcast for partners by Deriv. Remember, this podcast is for educational purposes only and does not constitute financial or investment advice. It is considered accurate and correct at the date of publication. Changes in circumstances after the time of publication may impact the accuracy of the video.
All right, let's dive into this Deriv API. It's like a toolkit, right, for building these awesome trading applications. We've got all this research here, notes and stuff, and we're going to break it all down today, get to the good stuff.
Exactly. We'll break down what it can do, how it works.
Before we get to that, I guess we should back up. Like, what exactly is an API, and why should anyone even care about this Deriv API specifically?
Okay, good point. Think of an API like a bridge. It connects your awesome creating ideas to the engine of Deriv's trading platform. So you can build like custom tools and stuff on top of what they already have.
So I wouldn't just be using Deriv's regular platform. I could make something totally unique.
Exactly. Yeah. It's like, imagine Deriv provides like the engine and the wheels.
Right.
And you, the developer, you design the body of the car, you make it your own. Mm. It's a custom trading experience. Mm.
That makes a lot of sense. Now, this research mentions four main things you can do with the Deriv API. Automation, customization, real-time data access, and something called markup commissions. Let's go through them one by one. What about automation? What's the strategic advantage there?
Okay, so imagine you've got these automated trading bots,
right?
They just run your strategies perfectly, 24/7. Even while you're sleeping. That's what the Deriv API can do.
Mm-hmm.
You're free from having to watch the markets all the time, and you take emotion out of the equation.
Oh, okay, I see. So it's not just about convenience. It's about like minimizing risk and making things more efficient.
Exactly, yep. And then you have customization with the API. You can build interfaces that fit your own, like your own trading style and your needs. Maybe you want, a dashboard that shows your portfolio in a visual way, or you need a tool that connects to a specific data source. You can create whatever you need.
So it's about control, building a trading environment that's, you know, totally aligned with your preferences and your strategy.
That's it. Yeah. And then we have real-time data access. The Deriv API gives you a direct line to streaming and market data, which is super important for decision making, especially for technical analysis and high-frequency trading.
So no more delays, no relying on other data feeds. That's got to be huge for serious traders.
Yeah.
Okay, let's get into this whole markup commissions thing. How does that work?
All right, so let's say you build this really cool trading application, right, using the Deriv API, something other traders would love to use. You can actually set a markup commission on the trades made through your app.
So it's like, I'm providing a premium service on top of Deriv's platform, and I get a cut.
Right, exactly. Like, let's say a trader invests $10 in a contract using your platform, and you set a 2% markup commission.
Okay, so if they win, let's say they get like $18 back, how does that 2% work?
You would make, 0.37 cents from that trade, 2% of the $18 profit. But it's really important to be transparent with your users. You have to tell them about this markup. Their initial investment, it's basically reduced by 2%. You know, so they're starting with $9.63 instead of $10.
That makes sense. But you need to offer something really valuable to justify that markup, right? Get people to use your platform. What would that be? What are some examples?
What do traders value? Personalized support. Mm. Access to really sophisticated bots. User-friendly interfaces that make complex analysis simple. Educational resources, things like that. Developers can build all that into their apps.
Okay. So it's a win-win. The developer earns some income, and the trader gets awesome tools and resources. I'm liking this. So let's say, like, I'm ready to build my own app. What do I do? Where do I start?
All right. First things first, you need to register your application through your Deriv account. It's pretty easy. Go to the app dashboard, give your app a good name, something that, you know, captures what it's all about, and then hit register now.
Okay, done. I've got my app name. What's next?
If you're going to do that, the markup commissions we were talking about, that's where you would set your fee. The percentage, you can go up to 3%.
All right. Registered. Potential commission is set. What's next in this whole app building thing?
Next is the OAuth setup. Sounds technical, but it's really all about security. OAuth lets users log into your app using their, you know, their Deriv login, but you don't have to actually deal with their passwords.
Okay. So it's like a secure bridge between my app and the Deriv login system. How does it actually work though?
Imagine you've built a mobile trading app. When someone tries to log in, right? Your app, using OAuth, sends them to Deriv's secure login page. Once they log in, Deriv sends them back to your app with a special token. It confirms their identity.
So my app never sees their actual password. It just gets this, like, confirmation from Deriv.
Exactly. Yep, it's a really common system. You'll need to provide a redirect URL. That's the page in your app where they land after logging in through Deriv.
Okay, got it. Redirect URL set. What's next in this OAuth thing?
Then you got to define the authorization scope. You're basically choosing which permissions your app needs. It's about setting boundaries.
So I don't just give my app access to everything in their Deriv account.
Right.
I pick and choose what it can do.
Yeah, exactly. Like if your app only needs to show the user's account balance, you'd select the read scope. But if it needs to execute trades for them, you'd need the trade scope. Choose the least amount of access you need, for security and all that.
Right. Don't ask for more than you need. Okay, I've got my scopes. What's the last step to get set up?
Last step, generate an API token. This token is, think of it like a key, a unique key. It identifies your app and lets it talk to the Deriv API on your behalf. You can find it in your Deriv account in the dashboard under API tokens.
So I'm basically giving my app a backstage pass to my Deriv account, but with very specific instructions on what it's allowed to do. And this token, I have to keep this super secret, right?
Absolutely. Deriv only shows you the full token once.
Yeah.
When you first make it. So copy it down and store it somewhere safe. Yeah. You need it for every single request your app makes to the API.
Like a secret password that lets my app and Deriv communicate. Got it. So how does this token actually work? What happens when my app is talking to the Deriv API?
Okay. So every time your app needs to, fetch data or make a trade, it sends a request to the API along with the token. Deriv checks the token, make sure it has permission, and then if everything looks good, it gives your app access or executes the action. That's how it keeps everything secure. Only authorized apps can use your Deriv account.
So it's like every time my app has to show its ID, its API token, to do anything on Deriv. And if I ever want to stop the app from accessing my account, I just cancel the token in my Deriv settings.
Exactly. You've got the control. Now, I know some developers out there are probably thinking about, all those markup commissions rolling in. How do they track that? How do they see how much they're making?
Yeah.
Deriv has a, they have an API endpoint that shows all your markup stats. Like a commission statement, you can filter by date range, application ID, or even the client's login ID to get really specific insights.
So no more guessing or like calculating by hand. This is making a lot of sense. But before we go crazy building our dream apps, let's see what other people have done. We have some research here on successful applications built using the Deriv API. Let's check those out.
All right, yeah. One that stands out is Trade AI. It's a mobile solution. Makes withdrawals and deposits easy, keeps things smooth. But the coolest part is the copy trading feature. Users can copy the trades of successful investors.
Copy trading. That's interesting. It's like having a mentor in the trading world, right? What other apps are out there?
Okay. There's free.systemapledge.com. It's an automated trading bot. Connects to the Deriv API to execute a specific strategy. It's great at analyzing market data in real time, predicting movements, and making trades based on predefined rules.
So it's like a little trading assistant working in the background following a proven strategy. What else? What other examples do we have?
There's also trader.ai.
Yeah.
It's known for being user-friendly, having powerful analytical tools, and of course, integrating with a Deriv API. It's good for beginners and more experienced traders.
So we have a mobile solution, an automated bot, and a platform for strategic insights. It's a good mix so far.
These are just a few examples, but you can see how versatile the Deriv API is. There's a lot of potential for all sorts of innovative stuff. Mobile apps, automated trading, strategic insights, you name it.
This is so cool. I love seeing what people have built with this API. There's so much more to uncover. We'll keep exploring the Deriv API after a quick break. Stay tuned. Those were some awesome examples. Really cool to see what people have made using this Deriv API.
Yeah, it is. And it's not just about those specific examples, right? It's the whole idea behind the API, empowering people, building a community. It's like democratizing access to these powerful tools.
I like that. So for our listeners out there, the ones who are feeling inspired, ready to jump in, what kind of support is there? Like if they want to get started with this Deriv API?
Deriv's got a great support system, a dedicated team just for API support. They're there to answer questions, help you with technical stuff.
Okay, good. Having reliable support is so important, especially with new tech. What other resources are available?
They have a really active developer community. People connect, share ideas. You can learn a lot from each other, even collaborate on projects.
The community aspect, that's huge. Okay, let's talk about security for a second. This is financial stuff, sensitive data, right? Security's got to be a big deal. How does the Deriv API handle that?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Security is top priority for Deriv. The API has all these, like, robust measures to protect data and make sure transactions are secure. We talked about OAuth 2.0 earlier, remember? That's the system that makes sure apps can access accounts securely without needing the user's actual password.
Right, OAuth. It's like a gatekeeper. Are there any other security things built in?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
The API tokens, those unique keys, they add another layer of security. They identify each app, give it specific permissions, and make sure only authorized apps can use the Deriv account. And you can always, you know, revoke access to a token.
Yeah.
Right from your Deriv settings.
So multiple layers of security. OAuth for access control, API tokens for specific permissions. Seems like they've thought of everything.
Yeah, Deriv's definitely got a strong framework in place.
Okay, good. Now, for the more technical folks out there, what skills do they need to use the Deriv API effectively?
Well, it helps to have some basic programming knowledge, but it's not a requirement. Deriv has really good documentation, tutorials, even code examples. So it's pretty easy to learn. Even if you're not a coding expert.
So even if you're not a programmer, you can still use this API. That's great. What about specific languages? Like, what do people usually use with the Deriv API?
It's pretty flexible. It works with a bunch of languages. Python, JavaScript, PHP, those are all popular choices. Developers can use what they're comfortable with.
It's like a multilingual API. Awesome. Okay, let's shift gears a bit. Innovation, we've seen some cool apps, but where do we go from here? What's the future of the Deriv API?
Ooh, the possibilities. One exciting area is like advanced trading algorithms, strategies that use, you know, machine learning and artificial intelligence. Yeah. That's getting really popular these days.
AI-powered trading. How would the Deriv API fit into that?
Well, think about it. The API gives you all this data, right? Real-time market data, historical data, and the ability to execute trades. It's perfect for training and running AI algorithms. Mm. Developers could build really sophisticated models that find patterns, predict market movements, and make trades automatically.
So the AI would have all the info it needs to, like, navigate the markets. That's fascinating. What else? What other innovative stuff do you see happening?
Personalized trading dashboards. Interfaces that are customized to each trader's needs. Imagine a dashboard that integrates with the API. It gives you insights, alerts, visuals, all tailored to your goals and your risk tolerance.
It's like your own personal trading command center. That's cool. Anything else? Any other innovations on the horizon?
Oh, yeah. Social trading features, community-driven tools. Imagine platforms where traders can connect with each other, share strategies, learn, even trade together. The Deriv API can make all that happen. It's got the infrastructure, the data access.
It's bringing that social aspect of trading, you know, into the digital world.
Very cool. Okay, let's zoom out for a minute. What about the bigger picture? How are APIs like this changing the world of finance?
They're like revolutionizing it. They're breaking down barriers, making collaboration easier, and driving innovation like crazy.
They're creating a more connected, more dynamic financial system.
Mm-hmm.
What about the Deriv API specifically? How is it contributing to all this?
It's a great example of how APIs are like democratizing access to these really sophisticated financial tools. It gives developers the building blocks they need, so individuals and businesses can participate in the markets in ways they never could before.
It's leveling the playing field, right?
Yeah.
Smaller players can compete and innovate alongside the big guys. What are the benefits of all this, of this API revolution?
Well, for one, things are way more efficient. APIs streamline stuff, automate tasks, faster transactions, lower costs, fewer errors.
It's like a digital boost for the financial system. Faster, leaner, more agile. What else? The customer experience is better. Businesses can offer more personalized services, make things seamless and intuitive. That's how you build loyalty these days.
It's not just about making things work better behind the scenes. It's about the end user. Makes sense. Any other benefits worth mentioning?
Innovation. APIs are like a playground for developers. They can experiment, create new solutions, push the boundaries. And that's leading to tons of new financial products and services.
It's like a financial renaissance. Wow. So much creativity, so much innovation. I'm really excited about this stuff.
Me too. And this is just the beginning. We're going to see even more amazing things in the next few years. APIs are going to keep changing the financial landscape, empowering people and businesses all over the world.
We've covered a lot today. The Deriv API, its power, the applications, security, its impact on finance. But before we wrap up, there's one more thing we need to talk about. We talked about the Deriv API, all the cool stuff you can build with it, and how it's changing things in finance. But we can't forget about, you know, the human element. Technology is just a tool, right? It's all about the people using it.
Absolutely. It's about how the Deriv API, or any tech really, can empower people, help them make better decisions.
Exactly. So for listeners who are ready to, you know, dive in and explore this API, what advice would you give them? What are some key takeaways?
Okay, first thing, have a vision. What are you trying to do? What problem are you solving? Having a clear purpose will, like, guide you through the whole process.
Start with the why, right, before the how. That makes sense. What else? What other tips do you have?
Don't be afraid to, you know, experiment. Try things out. You're going to make mistakes, but that's how you learn. That's the cool thing about the Deriv API. It's flexible. You can keep changing and improving your app as you go.
It's all about learning and getting better. Okay, what else?
The community. Connect with other developers. Share your ideas. Get feedback. Learn from each other. The Deriv developer community is it's a great place for support and inspiration.
Yeah, working together is so important. Okay, any final thoughts, any words of wisdom for our listeners?
The only limit is your imagination, right? Mm-hmm. The Deriv API gives you the tools, the resources, the community. You can bring your ideas to life. A trading algorithm, a custom dashboard, a social trading platform, whatever you can think of. It's all possible.
That's a great way to end it. So to all our listeners out there, get creative, explore the possibilities, and build something amazing. Who knows, maybe you'll create the next big thing with the Deriv API. Thanks for listening.
The products offered on our website are complex derivative products that carry a significant risk of potential loss. CFDs are complex instruments with a high risk of losing money rapidly due to leverage. You should consider whether you understand how these products work and whether you can afford to take the high risk of losing your money. Trading conditions, products, and platforms may differ depending on your country of residence. For more information about our offerings, visit our website at deriv.com.